I request all the panelists to please turn on their videos. So teamwork is what is required to do a successful case study, and teamwork is a secret that makes common people achieve uncommon results. With this, I, Dr. Tarini Pandey, Assistant Professor of Prestige Institute of Management, Gwalior, extend a warm welcome to our Honorable Chief Guest, Dr. Anil Bajpai, COO, Prestige Education Foundation, respected Deputy Director, Dr. Navita Nathani, ma'am, coordinator of the event, Dr. Sneha Rajput, ma'am, esteemed dignitaries, my fellow colleagues, and dear students, in the valedictory event of the 19th EFDP on Case Writing and Case Teaching 2021. A very good afternoon to all of you. First and foremost, I would like to invite the coordinator of the 19th EFDP on Case Writing and Case Teaching 2021, Dr. Sneha Rajput, ma'am, without whom this event would not have been possible. Ma'am, I would request you to kindly brief us about our successful 19th EFDP on Case Writing and Case Teaching 2021.
Thank you, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Thank you so much. Honorable Chief Guest of the occasion, Dr. Anil Bajpai, COO, Prestige Education Foundation and Head Prestige University, Indore. Respected Dr. Nishant Joshi, Director, PIMG, Gwalior, in absentia. Respected Professor Navita Nathani, Deputy Director, Management Department. Respected Dr. Tarika Singh, Deputy Director, Commerce, IT and Law. Eminent personalities from academic world, executives, research scholars, PIMG faculty and staff, and student volunteers. A very good afternoon to one and all. On behalf of Prestige Institute of Management Gwalior, it is my honor and privilege to welcome you all in the valedictory ceremony of 19th EFDP on Case Writing and Case Teaching 2021. In collaboration with CII and ISTD and publication partners as Case Center UK and FIIB Business Review by Sage Publication, a Scopus Index Journal. In total, we had 66 participants from 29 institutes, 14 states, and 5 participants from Bahrain and Nepal. The day 1 of FDP, that is April 1, 2021, commenced with the inaugural session, wherein the chief guest, Mr. Saurabh Sangla, ED Signet Group and Adroit Industry, guest of honor, Mr. Ashish Vashil, Chairman CII and MD Precision Industrial Systems, and respected resource person, Dr. S.S. Bhakar, Vice Chancellor, ITM University, gave their remarkable presence. The inaugural session was followed by a session on how to write a good case on opening paragraph delivered by Dr. S.S. Bhakar. Day 2, that is April 2, 2021, started with a session on how to write good case and opening paragraph delivered by April 2, 2021, started with a session on how to write case teaching notes followed by team activity among group on case development. Day 3, that is April 3, 2021, started with a team activity on case development, followed by a case presentation evaluated by esteemed panelists, Dr. Anil Bajpai, sir, and Dr. Harsh Halve, sir. Attendees were delighted to have their valuable suggestions. The case presented by the teams were, Team 1, headed by Dr. Nishant Joshi, presented a case entitled Sustainability of Renaissance in Educare in Post-COVID-19, a case study. Team 2, headed by Dr. Navita Nathani, presented a case entitled Earthrise Farms, Turning the Table Via Disruption. Team 3, by Dr. Garima Mathur, Effective Talent Acquisition at OHPL. Team 4, that is by Dr. Prabal Pratap Singh, presented a case entitled Rex Non-Protest Picare. Team 5, by Dr. Gaurav Jaiswal, presented a case entitled Search of Perfect Recruitment Strategies, a case of mutual fund distributor. Team number 6 presented a case entitled Lockdown Dilemma by Dr. Amita Maheshwari, headed by Dr. Amita Maheshwari. Team 7 was headed by Dr. Rituraj Baba. The case entitled was entitled as Having Them Leave or Having Them Stay, a case study on training needs. Team 9 has presented a case on marketing strategies by Dr. Nishif Manu. Team 9, headed by Dr. Richa Banerjee, the case entitled, I Don't Think Anybody Lost, Everyone Won. The team 10th team presented a case on HR strategies at ExxonMobil by Dr. Chanda Gulati. Team 11, headed by Dr. Rahul Pratap Singh Kaurav, presented a case entitled Global to Local, a Boon of Travel Agent. Team 12, by Dr. Nandan Malankar, presented a case on Janma's Bank amid the turmoil with courage. Team 13, by Dr. Praveen Arunkar, presented a case on challenges to face and to be tackled by hotel industry in post-COVID era, a case study. Team 14 was headed by Assistant Professor Pranshuman Parashar, sir. The case was EMI stove, key to remarkable success. Team number 15 presented a case on financial strategies. The team was headed by Dr. Pooja Jain. Team 16 was headed by Dr. Abhay Singh Chauhan. The title of the case was Box of Diamond with Two Rings. Team number 17 presented a case on a judgment that silenced Section 66A of IT Act. The team was headed by Professor Akash Gupta. Team 19 was headed by Dr. P.K. Singh. The title of the case was Demonetization, Is it the Opportunity or the Threat? A case study on Paytm. The day 4 commenced with the session on case teaching delivered by Dr. S.S. Bhakkar, sir. The entire event is backed up by a time-trusted team. The committees in the event were core committee, that is the one who was coordinating the entire event, was headed by Dr. Sneha Rajput, that is me, and my co-coordinator, Dr. Kishan Singh Rathore, sir. International Promotion Committee was headed by Associate Professor Dr. Garima Mathur. National Promotion Committee was headed by Assistant Professor Dr. Rituraj Babu. Local Promotion Committee was headed by Assistant Professor Dr. Richa Banerjee. Law Promotion Committee was headed by Assistant Professor Hariom Awasthi. Sponsorship Committee was headed by Professor Dr. Navita Nathani. Media and Publicity Committee was headed by Assistant Professor Dr. Nandan Valankar. The Publication and Type Committee was headed by Professor Dr. Tarika Singh. Printing Committee was headed by Assistant Professor Praveen Aronkar, sir. Registration Committee was headed by Assistant Professor Smrita Bhadoria. Inaugural and Valedictory Committee was headed by Assistant Professor Dr. Sunil Saxena. Next in line, we have the Guest Committee, which was headed by Assistant Professor Abhay Dubey. Online Sessions and IT Support Committee was headed by Senior Assistant Professor Nitin Paria, sir. Social Media Promotion Committee was headed by Assistant Professor Brahmanand Sharma. Now we have come to an end with the valedictory ceremony of 19th EFDP on Case Writing and Case Teaching 2021 in collaboration with CII and ISTD and publication partners as Case Center UK and FIIB Business Review by Sage Publication and Scopus Index Journal. With this, I would like to say that it's the beginning or the end. It entirely depends from where do you decide to look ahead or to look back. I would not leave this opportunity to thank the important contributors who extended their support as and when I need it. Special thanks to Dr. Nishant Joshi, sir, Professor Navita Nathani, Professor Tarika Singh, Associate Professor Garima Mathur, Dr. K.S. Rathore, the co-coordinator, Dr. R.P.S. Kaurav, Assistant Professor Mahendra Singh, Mr. Manish Dalmia, Mr. Yogendra Rathore, and yes, last but not the least, student coordinators Naina Keswani, Nishant Sharma, and Avantika Singh Sengar. That's all from my end. Aspire to see you all once again in the upcoming events. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for letting us know about the event. Now, I would like to take this opportunity to invite the participants of this event to share their experiences and feedback. First one we have is CA Ajay Lunawat, sir, who is an assistant professor at Rajgiri College. Please, could you please unmute?
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are clearly audible.
Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. It's a great pleasure for me to share my experience on this 4 days of EFDP on case study. In fact, it's a matter of great pride for me also to inform you that our institution got the highest score for our fourth NAC cycle across India. In fact, I had got various opportunities to attend FDPs and training programs at esteemed institutions, both at international and national level. But let me tell you very honestly, I have never experienced such a result-oriented workshop with very clear and quantifiable outcomes. You know, while we attend FDP, we get a lot of knowledge, we get a lot of information about case study, teaching and writing. But I can definitely say this workshop has gone one step ahead and where we got a great example of experiential learning. I think it was possible because of the power of the direction, the leadership and the teamwork. And this made each of us group to draft a case and that too within 48 hours. And I think most of us participants have done it for the first time also. So this workshop made us believe that collaborative efforts, they can, with clear defined goals, can create wonders and both efficiently and effectively. So when I look back on this 4 days of this EFDP, on behalf of everyone and myself, I can say that yes, I can write and I can teach case. So I'm really thankful to the entire Prestige Group, to the organizing committee. Thanks to resource person, Dr. S.S. Bhakkar, who has explained A to Z of case study, teaching and writing. Thanks to all the panel members for their constructive feedbacks. Special thanks to our team leader Abhay ji, co-leader Nidhi ji, Satish sir, and my institution colleague and my life partner CA Deepthi Lunawat, who was also with me in this training session. Special gratitude to Sneha Rajput ma'am for super conduction and coordination of this FDP. With lot of hopes of future collaboration, once again thanks to all the entire team for this memorable 4 days of experiential faculty development program. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. Second one we have is Mr. Rajneesh Verma, sir, who is an assistant professor at Indraprastha College for Women, Delhi. Sir, please could you unmute yourself?
First of all, a very good afternoon to one and all present here. Definitely, I would like to thank all the. I would like to congratulate the institute first for organizing such a wonderful event. I have been part of one event earlier also. I have attended one of the conference there, and again, after seeing the quality of things what you people are putting in the academic domain, it is remarkable. If you talk about the workshop, how you have just conducted the whole thing, this is definitely. In a beautiful manner, you have just conducted this thing. Most of the time when we people attend workshop and conference, we lack the practical aspect. But here, what we have seen, that things we are getting, it is in a practical manner, we can apply those things, we can learn by doing. So learning by doing is the best thing, what we can experience here. And this is different if we compare this institution with the elite management institution. I can say that you people are doing wonderfully well in terms of transmitting knowledge and you can say the research expertise to the faculty. And if you talk specifically from the perspective of faculty, what is required? From the perspective of faculty, it is required that we must learn different domains. And definitely if we talk about B school and such kind of institution, they always need to focus on the practical aspect, and we get the case, but most of the time we need to understand that how to crack it, how to present this thing to the student, how we make the student understand that how they can judge the case, how they can connect the thing in a practical scenario. So all in all, this is a wonderful effort what you have just put through in front of us, and I again congratulate all of you for conducting such a wonderful event. And definitely I would like to thank the coordinator, as we have requested few things during the workshop also, and she has just managed to provide all the things as and when required. And we are so much obliged to attend such thing. And thank you so much for giving me this opportunity to share my view along with people. And definitely we would like to get connected with you people in the near future also. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Next, we have Mr. Arjun Murthy, sir, who is an associate professor at IPER Bhopal. Sir, please, could you unmute yourself?
Am I audible, ma'am?
Yes, sir, clearly.
Yes, sir.
Very good afternoon to one and all present here. To me, this was an excellent FDP, learned a great deal and inspired to learn more. The concrete curriculum of the FDP was beautifully designed and executed to bring together the concepts, research, analysis and practice. Thanks a million to the Prestige Institute of Management Gwalior Group for organizing this much needed FDP in the area of case writing and case teaching pedagogy. One of the very best resource person, Dr. S.S. Bhakar sir, Vice Chancellor, ITM University Gwalior and former Director of Prestige Institute of Management Gwalior, who shared and taught us the relevant practices that I could use with clear and progressive steps. Thank you, sir. I appreciate the final discussion and feedback during the case presentation between the panelists. Thanks to my team mentor, Dr. Rahul Pratap Singh Kaurav sir, and all the faculty members for the fruitful discussions, Dr. Tarini Pandeji, Ms. Rishita Sengar ma'am, for the valuable contributions during the discussions. Thanks to Dr. Nishant Joshi sir, Director, Prestige Institute of Management, Gwalior, and to the event coordinator, Ms. Dr. Sneha Rajput ma'am, for keeping us all involved since the time of conception of this FDP till its final closure. Thanks one and all for providing us this platform for collaborative learning. That's all from my side now.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you to one and all for your motivating words. Let us now welcome our hardworking, learned, Honorable Deputy Director, Dr. Navita Nathani, ma'am. I would like to invite you, ma'am, to provide your valuable remarks on our 19th EFDP on Case Writing and Case Teaching 2021. Please, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
Respected Shri Anil Bajpayee, CEO of Prestige Education Foundation, chief guest of today's valedictory ceremony, Dr. Sneha Rajput, coordinator, 19th case writing workshop, Dr. Chanda Gulati, coordinator, 20th case writing workshop, participants from National and International Institute, media representative, faculty colleagues, staff members, a very good noon to all of you. I warmly welcome you all in the valedictory ceremony of 19th e-faculty development program on case writing and case teaching, collaborated with CII and ISTD, and publication partners are the Case Center and FII Business Review. First of all, I would like to extend my thanks on behalf of Director Dr. Nishant Joshi, sir, and on behalf of PIMG family to Bajpayee, sir, for accepting our invitation and being part of this valedictory ceremony. And I would also like to extend my thanks to Dr. S.S. Bhakar, sir, resource person of this workshop, for conducting informative sessions. Prestige Institute of Management is an autonomous UGC NEC accredited grade institute. It was set up in the year 1997 by Prestige Education Foundation in Indore under the visionary stewardship of its founder, Padmashri, Dr. N.N. Jain. The 19th edition of the National Case Writing Workshop aimed to develop hands-on cases during the course of the workshop. And the cases developed during these workshops are published and made available online by the Case Center, United Kingdom. As coordinator said that we have developed 19 cases in these 4 days workshop, which can be a significant contribution to PIMG repository of cases, and same can be published either in the Scopus Index Journal or in the Case Center. Some of these cases written in past have been used by management departments of some of the best universities and renowned B schools of the world, like the University of Florida, USA, Penn State University, Polytechnic Institute of New York University, USA, SPGen School of Global Management, Singapore, London School of Marketing, UK, and the list can go on and on. I was listening to the feedback of the participant since we have been organizing this workshop since long, and I was expecting some critical comments, some negative feedback, so that we can improve this. And in the next workshop, which we will be organizing in the month of April in the next year. But thanks to all, they have given a very positive feedback. This is the credit goes to the coordinator. The coordinator put a lot of efforts in, you know, organizing this workshop, and all the team members and the committee members who put their efforts to make this event successful. The business school model is rapidly changing as employers move away from seeking employees with theoretical knowledge toward those with practical knowledge and hands-on experience. This is where the case study learning comes in. Case studies facilitate development of the higher level of Bloom's taxonomy of cognitive learning, and nowadays have become a very important tool of innovative teaching pedagogy in B schools around the world. The case study is not only an excellent way for cognitive learning for students, but also improve their analytical and evaluative skills. Research proved that the students also would like to see the teaching pedagogy and teaching style before taking admissions. Basic problems which have been faced by academicians is that we are not getting good case studies in Indian context. Being the pioneer institute of this region, PIMG has been doing it so long and created a repository of these cases. Another important part of using this style is most of the academicians are not trained how to teach cases in class, as case study teaching requires deep engagement and challenge. Professors who are one way very good educators won't survive long in a case study environment. This case study writing workshop is a solution for both, where the hands-on session were there on how to write cases and how to teach the same in the classroom. I hope that the participants, under the guidance of resource persons and team leaders, have learned a lot from all these 4 days. And the next workshop will be in the next year, and the dates will be announced by the next coordinator of case writing workshop. Thank you so much for your patient listening. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your beneficial remarks. It's time now to unveil the brochure for our 20th FTP on Case Writing and Case Teaching 2022. I request the team to kindly come forward and do the honors. Please. Thank you so much. Before moving further, I feel profusely overjoyed to introduce our chief guest for the event, Dr. Anil Bajpai, sir. Dr. Bajpai is an alumnus of three of India's best known institutions. He graduated with honors in physics from St. Stephen's College, Delhi. Thereafter, he earned his bachelor's in electrical engineering with distinction from IISc Bengaluru. He further went on to complete his master's in management, PGDM, from IIM Ahmedabad. In 1983, Dr. Bajpai earned his doctorate degree in the area of total quality management. His corporate career spanned nearly 31 years before the foray into academia. The first phase of his corporate stint saw him shoulder responsibilities of management consulting at SB Birla Moria, sales management at Hindustan Motors, shop floor production, product management and sales and marketing of semiconductor devices, both at Continental Device India Limited, as well as Max Electronics Limited. The next phase began in 1997 through to 2010, where he led some of India's best known telecom companies in extremely arduous and hostile geographies. He set up literally from greenfield position, Airtel, Reliance Infocom, Vodafone operations in the capacity of business leadership position in MP, Chhattisgarh, Odisha and Assam. The corporate successes he achieved were in rapid rollout of networks, both technical as well as sales and distribution operations. He has held a very strong belief in the power of team building, mentoring, and driving ordinary teams to deliver extraordinary results. A strong believer in relationships, Dr. Bajpai, in his corporate career, has helped many young aspirants shape their destinies. Love for training, mentoring, and nurturing the next generation steered him towards academia, where he deployed the customer-first philosophy to create an exemplary environment in the KIIT School of Management, where he was the director for nearly 6 years. Since the last 1 year, Dr. Bajpai has been a part of Prestige Group at Indore. He's presently the COO aide, the Prestige Education Foundation, and the head of Prestige University. Sir, it is an honor to have you with us. I request you to please address the event with your valuable words. Please, sir.
Thank you, Tarini. I hope I am audible.
Yes, sir, clearly audible.
It is indeed a pleasure to see 225 participants on a Sunday afternoon when they would either be doing something different. And I believe Gwalior is not in a lockdown yet. Interesting. I am sure many of the participants are students and they would be listening very, very carefully to all the interactions that have happened so far for the past couple of days. My special thanks for conducting this workshop to Dr. S.S. Bhakar, our former director at Gwalior and the current vice chancellor at the IIMT. I hope and I think it's correct that Dr. Nishant Joshi is only having migraine and nothing beyond that. And he would recover from that very quickly. And his guidance and his leadership will take the institution to greater heights than ever before. Dr. Navita Nathani, and I always was confused about your surname, Navitaji. And remember the first interaction we had, I clarified. And since then, I do remember that there is a difference between a Nathani and a Nathwani. So I stand corrected each time. Dr. Navita Nathani, who is along with Madam Tarika handling the institute very, very ably, especially in these current times when Dr. Joshi has to travel a lot to Bhopal and to Indore for some university activity. Having said that, let me get back to the entire proceedings that happened since yesterday, or 4 days actually, from the 1st to the 4th today. I was part of some activity yesterday. And all those people who had to suffer at my hands because I was a little harsh in evaluating and commenting on some of the case presentations that were done. Believe me, there was absolutely no intent to put anybody down. The idea is to raise you guys up. I've been through this. I've been through the method of case teaching and case learning nearly all my life. I was a participant, and I don't call myself a student because none of my faculty used to call me a student in 1981. We were all called participants because we participated in learning. We participated in the process of gaining knowledge and gaining the rightful ability to go out into the field and perform as managers. The late Dr. Labdi Bhandari, the late Dr. M.N. Vora, and Dr. Abhinandan Jain, who currently is still active, will bear witness. Anybody who has heard their names or seen or Googled them ever, the late Dr. Pauline Garg. These were people who used to say, I am the 61st voice of the class. I am not your teacher. I will not teach you anything. I cannot teach you anything. Why? Because all of you are thinking human beings. All of you are analytical people. All of you are going to go into the market tomorrow and take your companies wherever you are working or you are heading to greater heights through your decision making. There was the late Dr. Ravi Mathai, Professor Ravi Mathai. I do not know how many of you have even heard that name. Professor Ravi Mathai was the founder director of IIM Ahmedabad. He, along with Vikram Sarabhai, the great scientist of India, who unfortunately died in an air crash in Italy, had built the Indian Institute of Management. And what did he do? He went on a trip to the US along with Vikram Sarabhai, spent 2 months at various universities, and was telling the professors there that you are guys who are earning in thousands and thousands of dollars. I want to get you back to India, and all I can offer you is 700 rupees a month. Are you willing to come and create history in the country? Of course, not everybody fell for this trap, but a few did. And those who did really made history. History in the sense that IIM Ahmedabad thereafter has gone from heights to heights, creating world leaders, creating CEOs of big corporations, you know, all over the world. What did IIM adopt? It adopted the Harvard method of the case teaching style. All right. So that was just to give you a little bit of history where the case method came from. The case method came from Harvard. We also got our earlier cases from Harvard. There were no Indian cases. And it was terrible. It was terrible for us to convert those dollars into rupees. It was impossible to fathom what it meant. But believe me, when we used to come back from lunch and at the door of our room used to be 600 pages of case to be read and discussed in the class next morning. Theory was never ever taught in a classroom. It was assumed that we are postgraduates. We understand what learning and teaching is all about. And we will arm ourselves with all the theoretical concepts before we get into class. But when we got into class, it was a nightmare for some and a huge learning experience for all. When I say nightmare, I mean that the professor, along with the rest of the classmates, would tear to bits anything and everything that any one of us uttered. Simple cases used to result in amazing learning. Amazing learning. For instance, I was sharing this yesterday with, I think, Dr. Sneha Rajput, that she comes from a family of physicians. She has many, many doctors in her family, and her husband is a surgeon himself. So I asked her, how do you teach medicine? Do you teach medicine by a drawing board? Do you teach medicine by a PowerPoint presentation? If every doctor learned medicine through a PowerPoint presentation, the first time he would go into a surgery, his hands would tremble. He would not know what to do. So therefore, how does the teacher, in this case, the senior doctor, teach the junior budding doctors? He takes them into the surgery while he's performing a surgery, and they watch, and he asks them questions right there, and they respond. If they're right, he gives them a pat. If they're wrong, he tells them what is right. This is exactly the case method. This is not only for surgery, this is for any case. Similarly, today if I were to ask you that there is a pandemic which has been going on for the last 13 months in this country and almost 18, 19 months across the world, it has led to lots and lots of positives and negatives. And for this case of the Indian government, if you were to write a case, how would you go about it? Yes, a lot of you have learned a lot. Yesterday, I was very impressed by some of the presentations wherein you've understood how to introduce a case. You've understood how to bring about the facts of the case in a very substantially understandable manner. You have also understood how to extract from the case what should be the learning. However, what you have probably, for the lack of time, I would say, because there was very little time for you people to write those cases, only 48 hours, I understand. You could have done a much, much, much better job had you got more time. What is it that you could have done better? For instance, if I said, write a case, and this is something I wish all of you to take back home as a task and try to conduct it along with your students or with your faculty colleagues or whoever else you can. But this would be immensely important. And that is, write a case about India. About India in the pandemic COVID-19. Put down all the facts that you know. Put down all the situational activity that has been done. Put down everything that the Prime Minister ordered, from banging the thali to observing lights together to a janta curfew and the lockdown. And what did we result in? All that, put that down, and at the end of the case, ask a few questions. And those questions are, where do we go from here? I'm telling you, this would create the blueprint of the next plan that the government should take. This is exactly what a case a proper case method can achieve. It can achieve planning at the highest level. It can achieve execution in the best possible manner. So I think you've had a wonderful time, all of you, and it's quite evident that even today there are more than 200 people who are participating in this valedictory session. I will end with just two little things, and these are little things which I keep repeating to everybody who I meet who is connected with management education. And again, these are things which, quote unquote, belong to the late Professor Ravi Mathai, who at some point in time was like a Dronacharya to me. He said, if I were to select from two people, one who has excellent skills but mediocre attitude, and another who has excellent attitude but substandard skills, who will I select? Big dilemma. Most organizations would say, this guy is more skilled. He knows more. Get him in. And that's where they fail. What Ravi Mathai says is, and I believe that, and I've done this all my life, all the 39 years of my working, I will go for attitude. Because I can always teach skill. And today, it's more relevant than ever before that skills need to be changed every 6 months. The world is rapidly moving. So somebody who understands SPSS is no longer used. Now there is advanced Excel, which throws SPSS out of gear. Where is ANOVIA? All those research techniques, which people had learned and they thought they were brilliant, they were skilled in research, are of no valid use anymore. So you can always teach new skills, but if there is no attitude, forget it. Forget it. So attitude is the most important thing. The second thing that I was taught, and I wish to convey this to you all, is that management, and I'm defining management for you, this is my modified definition from what the late Ravi Mathai dictated or said. And my definition of management is the art and science of generating alternatives, evaluating them, and suggesting the most appropriate method to solve a problem. Is that clear? Management is no more and no less. So the corollary from this is, if there is no problem, if there is no alternative, there is no problem. For instance, let me give you an example. There is one road from Gwalior which goes to Delhi. Is there another road from Gwalior to Delhi? If yes, then you have a problem. You have a problem of deciding whether you want to save time or you want to save money. Or you want to save time and money. So you have an objective function, you have boundary and initial condition, then you solve this problem. If there were more roads, however, if there is no other road, do you have a problem? You have no problem. You have no alternative, you have no problem. So in that case, all you need to do is just follow the available alternative. And that's when you say, I had no choice. So when you had no choice, why do you go around trying to find alternatives? You cannot. So please understand this, teach it to your students. It'll do a lot of good, as it did to me in my career. And I always looked for alternatives. And if I found that there was an alternative, then I got down to try and find which is the best alternative. And whenever I found that there was no alternative, I said, let's go ahead. don't waste time trying to solve something which doesn't even exist. Remember these little things, and I'm telling you, these are the cornerstones of every case writing and every case teaching method. And I will not call it solving because in a case, there is no solution. There are 61 solutions to every case that you will address in your class of 60 students. And all 61 may be right, or none of them may be right. Because in the marketplace, what succeeds is right. What fails is wrong. Reliance Jio did everything wrong. I was part of the team which got into Reliance in the telecom space. I was one of the leaders. We did a lot of wrong things and we did a lot of right things. And then Jio started, because there was a little bit of a difference between the two brothers, and the Infocom space was sent to Anil Ambani, and Mukesh Ambani was left with nothing in his plate in the telecom space. So what did he do? He said, I will build another telecom company. And he built Jio Telecom. Incidentally, if you write Jio on a piece of paper and then face it onto a mirror, it will say OIL, oil. So that was, oil is the business of Reliance, and Jio is what they want to do and control telecommunications in the entire world. Good luck to them. Why I say good luck? Because Reliance does not have a very, very strong history of long standing in any sector. They get bored quickly and move to another sector. They might sell this to somebody. But right now, it is the backbone of all education, all activity. The fact that you and I are communicating somewhere has got Jio in it. Somewhere there is a link which is being established by Jio and making Zoom possible. So anyways, I'm happy that you have very successfully conducted this four-day session. And the feedback that I heard from some very learned people, from IPER, from other institutions, amazing work. If it has held the interest of faculty for 4 days in these tough corona times, congratulations to the team led by, I think, Dr. Sneha Rajput, of course, under the guidance of Navita Nathani and Tarika Singhji, and Nishant Joshi, sir. Amazing work. Keep it up. But don't wait for the next year. I heard that this FDP will happen again next year. Why should we wait for the next year? If there is demand generated, why not do another one? Maybe one day long, maybe half a day long workshop, but do it next month. Do it every month till 90% of your teachers throw away the marker and the chalk. You understand what I mean? I want all of you to understand. Ajay Lunawat has just switched his video on, and I think he is interested in saying something. Yes, please, Ajay.
Sir, in fact, I was also thinking this has to be an ongoing exercise. Every month, everyone collaborates, and it becomes a contentious thing for the teaching fraternity.
I will use a very, very Marxian phrase to say this. At the time of the Russian Revolution, there was a phrase which became very popular, and that was, workers of the world unite. You have nothing to lose but your chains. So I say here, teachers and management teachers of the world unite. You have nothing to lose, everything to gain. So let's all come together, form an association of, why don't you take the lead? Sneha, why don't you take this lead and create an association of management educators in the state of Madhya Pradesh. All right. And I'm willing to give you one day a month, an entire day a month, in whatever you want me to, in whatever way you want me to do, and help this association to grow. We will make this a forum for creating cases, sharing information, sharing experiences, educating people, educating ourselves, and ensuring that MP has the best set of educators in the space of management education in the entire country. Sure. So maybe this may be a starting point, and it will go long and big, you know, reach great heights. So with that, if there are any other questions, I'm open to discuss. Otherwise, it's been a long day for all of you. So you can go and rest.
Sneha ma'am, include Kerala also.
Yeah, why not?
Sure, sir. I'm really delighted to listen to this. Thank you so much.
Dr. Gulati wants to say something, is it? Chanda Gulati, madam, you are muted. Yes. We can't hear you. You have to be louder.
I was about to propose vote of thanks and invite them again in the next FDP.
Excellent. No, I'll tell you what. This FDP was a virtual FDP. All right? And you all understood how difficult it is to coordinate things in a virtual manner. Corona will not be there forever. All right. It's going to go away in the next few months. Yes, we will all learn to live with it. We will wear masks and wash our hands more frequently. But Corona will permit travel, will permit meetings, will permit physical activity. So every 6 months, we should actually have a physical one. There is no replacement to the touch and feel. Ab dekhiye ki, if you were to buy telephone instrument, you will do it on Amazon. If you were to buy a pair of shoes, you will not do it on Amazon. You will go to a store, try out 20 pairs before you actually find the one that fits you, because the touch and feel cannot be just ignored. How many of us have experienced a disaster when we ordered some textile online? Absolute disaster. साड़ी ऑर्डर करते हैं तो जिस रंग का सोचा था वो तो पता नहीं मिलता ही नहीं है, फैब्रिक भी बदल जाता है. So, while we will meet monthly, or we can meet monthly for a very brief half day workshop, on sharing experiences, every 6 months it may be a damn good idea to meet by rotation at different institutions. तो एक बार ग्वालियर में हो जाए, एक बार. अजय जी आप कहाँ के हो?
सर करेंटली आई एम वर्किंग इन कोची केरला.
ओ माय गॉड, व्हिच इंस्टीट्यूट?
राजगिरी कॉलेज ऑफ सोशल साइंसेज.
RCSS.
Yes, sir.
And अर्जुन, how is सरदार जी?
Everyone is fine here, sir, at Bhopal.
Good. Give my regards to your boss.
Definitely, I would do, sir.
Sushmita madam wants to say something. Sushmita Bandyopadhyay, kotha bolo. Ha madam, ki bolechen?
Sir, we have to promote them as the panelists, then only they can speak.
Oh, I'm so sorry. She wants to
say. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I have unmuted. I have been allowed to unmute. Sir, actually, with due respect to you, your words are very valuable and I have learned a lot from you and from our respected coordinators and Dr. Estes Walker. It was very enlightening, and I have learned. And this corona regime has made me learn a lot in this regime, how to keep my health and how to study. And it gave me time to recover my research work. You know, the most important thing that I have been benefited from this one. And I needed to say one more thing, sir. Case study is very much useful thing for student, I know. I absolutely agree with you. But for some subjects like mathematical and computer related forms, technical studies also, I'm an industrial engineer as well. So I know that a theory is required. And after that, to apply that theory, how the theory is applied, case study is required. So in Jadavpur University, while I was studying, I have learned to learn the theories first and then applying it to the case studies, real case studies from which I have written the papers. And mostly I have used the secondary data because the primary data was not available to me. But it is really the need. If I just show some case study at the beginning of operations research class, nobody would be able to relate. So I will have to first depict the dynamic programming, and then I can depict how to apply those.
Susmita madam, I agree with you. However, I remember now very clearly, this is now almost 40 years ago, we had our first session, and many of you would know the professor. The professor was Professor Ravichandran, who was the director of IIM Indore for a few years. So he was my teacher. And there was a transportation problem. So we learned linear programming first. We knew how to create an objective function, define boundary conditions, initial conditions, and try to solve it by the graphical method, and then by the two equation, three equation method, by inequality method, all kinds of ways.
Yes, exactly.
And then came the case immediately.
Exactly, exactly. Morning, that's what I said.
So what was there was that even these little things that we did, we were told that this is your homework. In the class, yes, we will discuss the case.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That's what I said. Just that what I said.
Got it.
That background knowledge is required to apply the theory.
Yes,
in
but
the case.
Background, we were told,
is required.
This is our responsibility to learn. And the teacher will,
yes,
make
of
us
course
learn and apply the application. All right.
Yes,
thank
sir
you all so much for listening to all some useful and some not so useful stuff that I doled out to you all. And let's hope we can keep the ball rolling. And back to you, Dr. Rajput.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. But actually, we cannot thank you enough for your motivational, inspiring, and kind words. So without taking much of your time, I would like to now request Dr. Chanda Gulati, ma'am, coordinator of 20th FDP on Case Writing and Case Teaching 2022, to deliver a word of thanks.
Thank you, Tarini ma'am. Good afternoon to all. I deem it a great honor and privilege to propose vote of thanks on behalf of Prestige Institute of Management Gwalior in the valedictory session of 19th FDP on Case Writing and Case Teaching 2021.
You need to be a little louder, Chanda.
At the outset, I would like to express my gratitude to the chief guest, Honorable Dr. Anil Vajpayee, sir, COO, Prestige Education Foundation, for the thought-provoking address. I thank him for sparing his valuable time to address the gathering. Thank you so much, sir. The success of this FDP owes much to the guidance and support of our esteemed director, Dr. Nishant Joshi. I thank him for his encouragement, guidance and providing a stimulating environment for such an educational development. Thank you, sir. I take opportunity to extend our gratitude to the distinguished panels, Vajpayee sir and Harsh Halve sir, for their constructive and valuable inputs. I acknowledge the presence and express sense of obligation to Dr. Navita Nathani, Deputy Director of Management, and Dr. Tarika Singh, Deputy Director, IT, Commerce and Law, for their continuous guidance in the successful execution of this workshop. Thank you, ma'am. I must mention my deep sense of appreciation for all the participants attending the workshop. I thank all the members of various committees and all the faculty members and staff who have been involved in this FDP for last several months. Without their cooperation and full support, this FDP would not have been possible. I thank ISTD and CII for associating with us in this case writing workshop 2021 and the publication partners too. I acknowledge and thanks all the participating organization, Earthrise Infra, Renaissance, SRF, Precision, Godinga, Vikram Woolen, Muskan Foundation, JB Mangaram, Hotel Central Park, Punj Lloyd, ExxonMobil, Compton Greaves, Motilal Oswal, Jana Small Finance Bank, Bajaj Finserv, Paytm, Brilliance Academy, and Hike Education for facilitating us during this workshop. My sincere thanks to the print and electronic media for their presence and giving excellent coverage of the workshop. My special and hearty thanks to the student volunteers who extended their support and untiring efforts. This vote of thanks would incomplete if I do not thank the coordinator, Dr. Sneha Rajput, and co-coordinator, Dr. K.S. Rathore, whose sincere efforts for day and night has brought this FDP before you all successfully. Last but not the least, I thank you all for being the wonderful audience and invite you all to rejoin us in the 20th Faculty Development Program on Augmentative Case Research Skills for Educators to be held in April 2022. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you so much, ma'am. With this, once again, I would like to thank everyone for taking out your valuable time for this event. Hope you had a great time. Be safe. Have a good day.
Thank you so much, sir.